Hello, in this Affinity Publishing tutorial, we are continuing our tour of the toolbar, and we are up to the picture tool. I'm going to talk about both of these two picture frame tools together in one video. So let's take a look at what the picture frame does. So just like a picture frame on your wall, it's a container that holds your pictures or photos, whatever illustration you want. So with the tool on, I can just drag out by holding my left mouse button a frame on my document. I can do the same thing with the round one. And let's make it an oval. And then if I hold shift while I do this, I will get a perfect circle. Same thing with this rectangular one. If I hold shift, I will get a perfect square. So now we have some frames. Let's take a look at some of the options. So what I want to do is I'm going to click on this one. I still have a frame tool selected, and it puts a bounding box around it, so I know that this one is selected. Now up in the contextual toolbar, I've got some options here. So let's start out by placing an image. So I can place an image by just clicking this button, Replace Image. And I will just pick one, and this put the image into my frame. Now I can use this slider down here to scale it up and down. And I can use these controls here in the middle and just hold my mouse button and drag it around to wherever I want. I can also use this rotation to rotate it within the frame. Now notice that the frame itself is not moving, only the picture within the frame. If I want to move the picture and the frame together, I need to grab this little button up here and rotate it that way. So let's take a look at some of the other properties. So if I take this slider down, you can see that I have a rectangular frame, and let's actually exaggerate that a little bit. But my picture is a perfect square. So over here we have a tab that says Picture Frame Properties. So let's look at what some of these properties are, and we're just going to start fresh here. So use the same image that we know is a square, and I have a rectangle frame here. So I'm going to start with scale to max fit. And so this is going to fill the frame so that the entire frame has picture in it. However, it's not going to do any sort of stretching or changing of the aspect ratio of the picture itself, but it will be cropped. So let's put that square image back in there, and you can see that my entire frame is filled, but it didn't stretch out or distort the picture in order to accomplish it. What it did, if we click on this little slider, is it basically took the width of this frame, this being the longest part, and it placed the image over it at a size that would fill it in this direction. Now, if I had a vertical frame here, it would have done the opposite. It would have filled it so that the whole vertical was filled. In fact, let's stretch this guy out. We'll get rid of our round one. And let's select this one and put that same image in there. And so now it has filled it vertically. And when we click on this, we can see that the edges of it are overlapping on the left and right, so it's like it cropped it to this area. Now, if we said we don't want this part, we want this part over here, we can use our controls to move it over so that only the part we want to see is showing. Okay, so that is the first one, scale to max fit. So it's basically going to keep your image undistorted, but it's either going to scale it up or down so that it fills the widest dimension of your frame. So next property is scale to minimum fit. So it will scale it so that the aspect ratio is still maintained, so it's not going to stretch it, but it may not completely fill the frame. So in this case, it filled it by maintaining the image, but filling it in this shorter direction, which means we have some empty space on either side. Stretch to fit means it's going to ignore the aspect ratio, so it's not going to keep it a perfect square. it's going to try and fill it no matter what size my frame is. So when I click stretch to fit, it stretched out my image this way. And when we click on this, we can see that the whole image is in there. It just stopped treating it as its original perfect square and stretched it out so that it fit in both directions. And then none means that the picture won't be scaled. Now it's not doing anything right now because I have been playing around with some of the other settings. But let's go ahead and just delete this. We will create a new frame here and we will put the image in. Let's just double check that we are on none. So we'll put the new picture in here. And it didn't scale it at all. It put it in its original size. And this was something I used an AI generator for, so it does not have a very big dimension. I think it's like 1024 pixels square or so. So it's keeping that 1024 pixels and just putting it into the frame at its exact size. It's not doing anything to try and stretch it out. It's not doing anything to try and fill the frame. So let's take a look at one more thing that we have here, and that's this anchor section. So I have this unscaled picture at actual size in my much larger frame, and I have the possibility to kind of change where it anchors to. So if I click this top left corner, it's going to move it to the top left corner. And as I click all these different points, that's where it is orienting it within the text frame. And if I want it in the middle, I click the middle one. Okay, so the same thing happens with the round one. So let's put this picture in the round one now, and we have all the same options. We've got a square picture in a round frame, and the square is still there. We can still move it around within there. It's almost kind of creating a bit of a mask-like effect within this picture frame. We have a couple other little buttons here. I can never get this to do anything, so leave it in the comments if you know what this does. But this one here, size picture frame to content, will adjust your frame to best fit the picture. So it's sort of the opposite of what we were doing here with the properties. Now we are, instead of manipulating the picture to fit the frame in different ways, we're manipulating the frame to fit the picture in its best manner. All right, so I hope you found that helpful. Thanks for watching.